Hi, my name is Emily, and I'm going to be teaching a little section of the Jellicle Ball today from Cats the Musical. Woo! Cats was choreographed back in 1981 by Gillian Lynn, and what I'm going to be teaching today is the original choreography that she set. It was revolutionary at the time because no one in their minds had ever seen anything like dancing cats in unitards, basically. It had never been done. And the sun's coming out. There are lots of versions of Cats circulating out there. There's the most recent one that you could have seen at the movie theater, or the one that you saw on Broadway last year, a few years ago, or out on a national tour. You could have seen one traveling around Europe, or in Asia, or on a cruise ship. There's a lot of versions of Cats out there in circulation. But what I'm gonna be teaching is what Gillian Lynn set 30 years ago. So it's really cool to be able to pass down this choreography from generation to generation because it's kind of not seen anymore. A lot of people take their artistic liberties and they will just go off and create a new type of Cats, which is awesome, but it's also really cool to preserve an iconic piece of choreographic history. So I'm gonna teach a little section called Copeland. There's a lot of dancing that happens throughout the entire show, but the Jellicle Ball is one of the most exciting moments, basically. The whole tribe of cats comes together and they almost do this like ritualistic tribute dance to their tribe. And Copeland is right whenever the music is building and it's getting real excited, and Grisabella is gonna be downstage left. The emphasis is gonna be on getting her out of here. And I didn't even say who Grisabella was. Grisabella was part of this tribe of cats until we kind of shunned her a few years back. And she is old and tattered, and she, on this one occasion, is trying to join our tribe. And she shows up in the middle of this dance, and she wants to join us. But unfortunately, we want nothing to do with Grisabella, so we are trying to get her to go away. Go away, Grisabella. I have my trusty animal print bike shorts on, and I have these awesome hip-hop sneakers because I'm in a field. As you can see, we don't have our studios right now, but we do still have our bodies, and we can still be creative. If you want to put some animal print on just to like have even more fun with it, go find some cat ears, go put a tail on, whatever. Got my cast jacket on. Whenever we dance in the musical, we never have human hands. We always have paws or claws. So whenever we're doing this choreography, make sure that you remember, we're not like gluing our hands together like this, but we always have energy that's kind of keeping our fingers together, if that makes sense. So we're not like aggressive blades. We have nice, relaxed, fluid fingers or claws. Hi, Emily here. So I wanted to pause the video real quick to say that I couldn't film a warm-up where I was because it was about to rain and there were burrs and things on the ground that made it difficult to do a full body warm-up right where I was. However, that does not mean that you are not allowed to warm up your body before we do this choreography. It would be ideal if you were doing this class after a ballet bar or after a ballet class. However, if that's not the case, I want you to still move your body for at least 10 minutes beforehand. So my advice would be, as a little assignment from Miss Emily, would be to go to the Cats album, if you can find it on Spotify or Apple Music, and pick 3 songs that you want in your warm-up. One song can be for cardio, one song can be for stretching, and then the last song can be for strengthening. I want you to really work on getting your body nice and warm, and then I want you to also focus on your hamstring strength as well as your hip flexors. Those are going to be the 2 big muscle groups that we're kind of working with in this piece of choreo, so it's really important that they're nice and warm. So spend a little bit extra time on your hamstrings and your hip flexors. So spend a good amount of time in a runner's lunge. And then last song, like I said, do some planks, do some abs, some push-ups, tricep dips, whatever it might be. Just get your body moving before we proceed with the choreography, and good luck. The first thing we're gonna do before we do any dancing is we're gonna warm up our neck, because I don't want anyone to wake up tomorrow with a broken neck because of what is about to happen. Start with four tilts, right, left, right, left. We're gonna look right, left, look down, up, and then we're gonna go front, back. We'll do two circles to the right and then two circles to the left, and then we're gonna manually hold our head in different directions just for good measure. All right, here we go. So we have one, two, three, four. Look right, right, left, right, left. Shoulders down, look down and up and down and up and bird. Circle to the right and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Again, to the right, two, three, four, five, six, seven, to the left, big head. One, two, three, four, shoulders down, six, seven, eight. Last time. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then now let's clasp our hands together like this, put it behind our head, and look down. Gently pull the back of our head down to the ground, not with a ton of pressure, but just enough to give it an extra little stretch. And now let's take our right hand, put it on the left side of our head, and gently pull it away from our left shoulder. Let's look up to the sky and down at the ground. Other side, left hand, right side of our head, and we pull it across. And we look up to the sky and down at the ground. Oh, there was a fly on me. And last time, let's just gently look up into the sky, resting our head in our hands, and let's go. We're basically all taking a nap on each other, and then we hear the music and we hear that something is about to happen. So we sense that there's danger near, maybe an intruder potentially coming from the downstage left corner. Maybe her name is Grisabella. We don't know yet, we just know something's happening, but we can feel the energy of it. So this is the first group, which is what I'm gonna be teaching. Run up to, we're gonna run 5, 6, 7, 8. On 8, we're gonna be in nice, strong second position, facing downstage left corner. We're gonna sway our body back and forth, right, left, and our arms are gonna be our tail. We're gonna pinch our shoulders behind us, and we're gonna sway to the right and to the left. You know when you see a cat who acts like it's like better than everyone else? You know, and they're like, they swish their tail. That's essentially what we're gonna be doing here. So we sway to the right and we sway to the left. And we're gonna look over our shoulder, kind of like we're looking at our booty as we stick it out. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From here, we're gonna glue our elbows into our sides and we're gonna have this biggest, craziest jazz hands you've ever seen out directly out to the sides, as far back as you can push it. Some of us don't have a ton of shoulder mobility, so just think engage and like palms forward, but like pushing back. From here, this is why we warmed up our neck. Get ready. So just the head goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I'm already dizzy. We're gonna do that twice. So the rest of the body goes, so we're in this strong stance. We're gonna go one, and we're in a demi-plie too. So many things to think about. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. And on 4, we're gonna straighten this right leg, sit into the right hip, and we're gonna pop our left toe. And we're gonna tilt our head to the right. And then we reverse it to the left. So then we go 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back to the left. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, so that's 3 8 counts right there. 3 little 8 count intro. Let's try it all together. So we have 2 tail swishes and then 4 sections of crazy necks. I don't think there is a name for this, but I would call it the broken neck section. I never forgot to warm up my neck after learning this and doing this a few times because it's painful. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. How did we do? I can't see you, so I hope it went okay. If you didn't get it, pause, rewind, try it again. I'm gonna go on. So after do 5, 6, 7, 8 with this right toe popped, we're gonna go into what I call the bow and arrow position. So take your bow, pull it back, and then point it at the ground. The right elbow will be shooting into the sky. And again, we have our pause. See, we're not in jazz hands. We have our pause right now. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull up on one, and we're gonna hit a nice high passe, high releve, straight leg, and we're gonna be kind of torquing our body down to the ground to this diagonal. It's kind of hard to hold, but this would be it if I wasn't on releve. I'm also in a field right now, remember that. So we have one, step it out behind you on two straight legs and a high releve. Upper body does not change. We're gonna pump our right heel back, 3 and 4. It's really awkward because we're not dropping out of releve, we're staying lifted. So again, we have 1, 2, pump, 3, 4. From here, we're gonna bring our arms to first position. We're gonna go into a deep second and we're gonna drop down and then we're gonna hit a nice a palma, a little open first arabesque up into the sky, energy shooting out of both fingertips, looking up over the right hand. Yeah? So again, that 8 count goes. We have 1, 2, hit, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold on to it for as long as you can because we're gonna repeat it a second time. Oh. Here we go, ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, pump, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, 1, 2, pump, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8. It's a gamble. You really gotta be on your leg for this one because if not, you're gonna be all over the place. Okay, so next up, I'm gonna teach a section called Swiper No Swiping. That's not Jillian Lynn's terms, that's Emily's terms for how I would remember it in the show. So we just did 1, 2, pump, 3, 4, 5, 6, bring it back, 7, 8. Our arms are gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna basically pull across our body, and our palms are gonna be facing behind us. And again, with our paws right here. So we have swiper, no swiping. The way we get into that, we're actually gonna do a turn around our right shoulder. So after we do 1, 2, pump, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, make sure our weight is on our left foot because we're gonna step around basically and kind of pirouette, or maybe PK is a better term, over our right foot around our right shoulder. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah? Let me show you again. So we just did 1, 2, pump, 3, 4, and 5, 7, 8. Swiper, no swiping. Yeah, so we bring our right arm around, and as we do that, we're gonna pick up our left foot and then step it out into a nice wide parallel second position. Facing downstage left corner. Grisabella is here, and we are now trying to get her to go away. So we do 1, 2, 3, 4. We do 4 hip ticks to the right. We go 5, 6, 7, 8. And they're kind of small. It's not like 5, 6. There's no time for that. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're gonna slowly lower our upper body over as we keep our chest open, basically. Our focus stays the same. All that's happening is that we're hinging at our hips. From here, it's time to go get Grisabella and tell her to leave. So we're gonna step with our right foot and right hand at the same time. We go one, paw forward. We're gonna stay in a deep plie too. So we're not going one, two. We're staying down. We go one, two. We go right, left. One, two, three. One more step after that. Right, left, right. Touch, passe, down. Then we're gonna relax our elbows down, relax hands, and then we're gonna go five, six, seven, eight. And we're gonna look over our left shoulder. Basically, in cat language, we're saying, get away from us. So that section goes, swipe or no, swiping, hit, 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 hit. One, two, three, four, a five, six, seven, eight. Yeah? Let's glue it all together from bow and arrow. Does that sound good? Here we go. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, a five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, a five, six, seven, eight. One, three, a five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, a five, six, seven, eight. Moving on. We just did five, six, seven, eight. We're gonna swirl our arms just like that. It's a scan, basically. So we're gonna go around, and then our left arm is then gonna kind of be like, if we had a cape, it would be like, whoosh, I'm whooshing my cape around. Lower body goes one, two, a rond de jambe. That's why we have to stay in ballet, because it's gonna show up everywhere we go. And Jillian Lynn said it's time to do a rond de jambe en l'air in the Jellicle Ball. So we just did six, seven, eight. We're gonna go one, two. I can't tell because I don't have a mirror if my leg is parallel to the ground. Should be around 90 degrees, give or take. We can't be too hard on ourselves. We are probably in our living room right now. So we did six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. We go forced arch, drop our heel. From here, we're gonna go five, six, seven, and eight. Like a scared cat that has just been like, you know, whenever you see a cat, it's basically like, does that make sense? So again, from Zorro's scan, we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Maybe, kind of. Let's go over some of the specifics again. So we swirl around, one, two. That's a lot that's happening. If you want to keep it lower, totally. A nice little like dégagé height, ronde en l'air, go for it. One, two, toe, heel, forced arch, drop the heel. From here, we bring our arms through and then we unfurl them behind us. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then you're gonna land, unfortunately, in forced arch. So it's not easy. So we jump and then try to keep your weight in your toes. If you can, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Before we go any further, shall we put this all together from the beginning, just with counts? Because it's kind of quick, the music is, so let's be sure we know the counts. My neck is already like a little bit unsure about what is gonna happen, but that's okay. Here we go, ready? How does it start? Okay, side note, I made a mistake. I totally forgot about the very first eight count of the dance. I was like, something is not right. I don't know what I'm missing. There's a wasp right there. Hi, sir, get away from here. So my bad. Let me go ahead and teach it right now. And we're just gonna tack it on to the very beginning. I knew this didn't seem right. That's okay, it's been a few years. The very first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna step out right, left, kind of like swipe or no swiping earlier. And we're gonna go hit and hit and hit and hit. See, we already knew it. We just do it at the beginning as well as like 10 seconds later. Yeah, so walking through the whole dance. Here we go. I wanna make sure my wasp friend is left. I don't know, ready? Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Swish to the right, swish to the left. Jazz hands, one and two and three and four, five and six and seven, eight. One and two and three and four, five and six and seven, eight. Here we go. One, two, three, four, a five. Seven again, one, two, three, four, a five, six. Again, one, three, a five, six, seven, eight. Right, left, step, touch, and hit. Six, seven, swirl. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Yeah? Going on. We are going to do the hardest step in the whole dance. We're gonna go from this position to this position and not fall over. So basically we have to go from this hinge. We land our hiss jump in a forced arch. And then from here, I'm gonna do it on flat foot. We're gonna pivot, basically fouetter around to then be in a, we're gonna face stage left. We're gonna have two giant claws above us and we're gonna have a parallel open attitude situation. So many things to think about. So we just did one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three. On two, three, we're gonna kind of rev back. Again, I'm gonna do it on flat. We're gonna go two, three. So what's happening is our whole upper body is a statue. The only thing that's moving is this left hip. It's bending us back and forth. So we go one, two, three, lay out four, five, six, seven, and big swipe. This is the hard section. And even people in my cast, dancers of all ages and sizes and levels and all of that can admit that this is hard. So we go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. We stay on this left foot is still gonna be in a forced arch whenever we swivel around. We go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, hiss. That's one of the only times you're allowed to hiss, but you're allowed to hiss right there because Grisabella is in this corner. So all of this, that's like turning your back basically. So when we do Zorro's cape, that's when we're showing her that we don't want anything to do with her, yeah? So then we go hiss and then we come back to her with this like scary stance basically to show our power. And then we get hinge, hinge, lay out. And then I want those swipey arms to come from like your back basically. So you're gonna step out. Yeah? Let me see if I can manage this in my field. So from Mask of Zorro, we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. So this next section, after we scare Grizz, we basically have to gain composure again, and we do what I call the, it's like the fencing section. Almost like we, you know, they have like quick footwork, and they're like, hi-ya, hi-ya. I don't know, I maybe just offended a lot of people who do fencing. Anywho, so we have eight. We're gonna do a right batma. We go one, two, three, four. Just like that. Eight. Gather it in, whack three, step four, and we're gonna open. What we're gonna do is we're gonna have the whole world in our hand. It's like a claw, like this. Seven, eight. We have one, two, three, four. And then we're gonna step. This right foot is in forced arch and we're looking over to our right hand. We're gonna step with our left foot behind. We're gonna go five, six, seven. So three steps, right, left, right. And then on eight, we're gonna flip to face up stage. And we're gonna bring our hand into our chest like this. So that was 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We développé, we go 1, 2, 3, 4. Opposite arm and leg. Left leg goes up, right leg extends back. Whenever we bring our left leg down, we're gonna bring our right arm across the center of our back, and then we're gonna do a little like swirly motion with our arms whenever we step. So we just did 8. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. Step 5, 6, 7, 8. And that's it. So that is kind of a little tricky situation because you're having to do opposite steps. So we cross behind and behind. So it goes right, left, right. So when we face upstage, we have right, left, right. Whenever we step with our right foot, our arm is gonna swirl out. When we step with our left foot, our swirl back across, and then with the right foot, we swirl back open again. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we go, ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, whack, 3, step 4, 5, 6, 7, twist. 1, 2, 3, down, 5, 7, hiss, 1. So what's happening is this whole time we have been dancing as a group, everyone's been doing the same thing, but we're separating into two different groups because then is a giant section of big grand jetés as we leap in between each other. But I think that's gonna get a little hectic if you're in your living room or your basement or your bedroom or your kitchen. So we're just gonna stop right there. But we did it! Shall we walk through the whole thing with counts and let's just see what happens. Give it our best go. I'm in a field with insects flying around. It's not ideal. Let's do it. So with the correct beginning, which let me review, we step out, swiper, no swiping. And it comes up to passe too. So we step out and out, and 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we go into the swirl, swirl, 2 8s of that, and then into bow and arrow. Okie doke, let's do it, here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 3, 5, 6, swirl your tail to the right, 5, 6, 7, heads, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hiss. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 7, 8. And that's it. Music. This.